everybody. I'm going to tell about prehistoric animals. This is Triceratops. Triceratops, when its head pressed warm, then they put their food near to their faces. Temperature's hot, they put their fur back. Like elephants, flapper ears need to cool. This is a T-Rex. Actually, the skin of the T-Rex was really rough. Like crocodiles, all bone skins are rough. This is a Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus has both and let its cousin to a crocodile. Even both have snouts to catch fish that live on water or in the land. This is a Stegosaurus. A Stegosaurus has the beak is not straight. It's like curved a little bit, like parrots. And the head of the Stegosaurus looks like a warthog. This is a Pteranodon. Pteranodon has wingspans very long. And like albatross. And even Pteranodons don't have feathers actually. It has wings, little hair growing on. It's like a bat. This is Stegosaurus. Stegosaurus, cousin to an elephant. And it has short and thick legs. Don't they? Archaeopteryx. For a fine dinosaur. It has mouthful of teeth, big tail, big claws, like a bird. But there are two differences between these birds. This is Archaeopteryx has a mouthful of teeth, but birds only have a beak. Velociraptor is a bat, flying mammal. It can walk on four. It can be a little far. It can walk on four legs or two. This is a dolichos. A dolichos. When the predators are about to eat them, they hide in their shells. It's cousin to the turtles. They live on land or also water. Saint-Nazaire was a snake for a time, promoted to a snake. And how does it move? It slithers by without walking with its arms and legs. Simulestes was prehistoric mouse. It both have sharp claws to climb, and they have a soft fur skin. Pretty like mouse. Tolotus is promoted if it's a prehistoric mouse. I mean squirrel. It's cousin to a squirrel, but there are two differences between these two squirrels. Squirrels actually have a bushy tail, and Tolotus has only a straight tail. On the next step, listen, Ankylosaurus of the armor is pretty rough, and also it's thick. And they even have small, thick legs. Cousin to a ten-banded armadillo. Armadillos can roll up into a ball, but Ankylosaurus doesn't. This is Hesperornis. Hesperornis is a prehistoric duck. It flaps her wings. And both cannot fly far. At next time. No, I forgot. And even they use their tail to swim fast. This is Cretaceous Rhino. It's a prehistoric shark. It has gills to breathe. Even they have also a good sense of smell. And even got lots of teeth. This is a brachiosaurus. Brachiosaurus was a prehistoric dinosaur. Like, it's cousin to a giraffe. But there are two differences between these animals and dinosaurs. The brachiosaurus has a long neck, and small thick legs for stomping. And this one, and giraffe, has long legs for running. And this is Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus was a prehistoric animal. It has a hump on the back like camels. Iguanodon was a prehistoric a dinosaur. It walks on four legs or two, but iguanas are only in four. This is a huge mammoth. Mammoth is cousin to an elephant. It got a long, curved tusk and furry skin. Like elephants, it has a small and soft skin. Dinocotherium. Dinocotherium has small horns and small tusk trunk and small ears. Pretty small dinosaur. Indicotherium. Indicotherium was the biggest animal of all. Percoptodon. Percoptodon was a prehistoric kangaroo. The head of it looks like a cat. But they hold young ones in their pouch. Okay, thank you for listening to the Prehistoric Animal Facts. Goodbye.